Hello everybody, here we are. I totally forgot to let you know that I was doing this today, but here we are, surprise. It's time for the monthly book wrap-up for April. And I will say I haven't read as much this month as I have in previous months, but I mean, I still read a lot, but I just feel like I was binging the Harry Potter books, and now that I'm done with them, I didn't know where to turn. So it's been a different month of reading this month, but still really good. So I'm excited to share what I've been reading. And as always, I have linked my favorites that I've been reading in my Amazon storefront, which you can click in the link in my bio if you are interested in grabbing any for yourself. And also, if you are not already on the app Goodreads, you should totally download it because it's really cool. I've talked to a lot of you guys about it, but it has changed the game for me with reading because you can add friends on there, which is really cool. Oh, sorry. And then you can also see what other people are reading, and you can look on there and there's tons of ratings on books and reviews that you can see. And if there's a book you want to read, you can add it to your want to read list. So when it's time for a new book, you can kind of look and see like what's already on your list of things that you want to read. And then you can set a goal for the year and add books towards that, so you can kind of see your progress. Anyway, I know I've talked about it before, but it's just really fun. So I thought I would mention it again, just in case you have missed it. All right, let's just get right into it. So this month I did finish in the Harry Potter series. At the beginning of this month, I was reading The Order of the Phoenix, which is the fifth book. I finished it, and then I read The Half-Blood Prince and finished with The Deathly Hallows. And I'm honestly so sad that it's over. I had to like grieve a little bit when it was over because I felt like I was so invested in the series for, gosh, the last 2 months, 3 months since I started reading them, and I loved them. It was so much fun reading them. It was like really nostalgic and whimsical and fun. And yeah, if you haven't read them, I highly recommend it. They're just a really fun read, an easy read. You can really get into them. And it's been fun for me because I've seen the movies before. So every time I've read a book, I would watch the movie afterwards. And it was just cool to kind of see like all the details that they'd never shared in the movies. But obviously the movies are still really good too. So now that I'm done, I'm trying to convince Christopher to take me to Universal Studios so I can go to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. If you've been and you think I should go, please tell me in the comments because I'm trying to convince Christopher that we need to take a trip. But yeah, so that's on my to-do list. I would love to go there and just experience it because I feel like now that it's over, I'm like, what do I do? As far as fiction, like, where do I go? I feel like nothing can compare to the Harry Potter series. And if you've read it, you probably understand. But I did start a new fiction this month, and I let you guys vote on which one I would read. I'm not done with it yet, but you guys chose All the Light We Cannot See. I'm almost halfway through. It's taken me a little while to get through this one because it is, well, number one, it's just a very different style of book from Harry Potter, and it's very poetic, and it's really beautiful. It's an incredible book so far. I'm not super, like, I guess I'm getting to the part where there's really a lot going on and it's getting good. But I think because I read Harry Potter last, it took me a while to get into this one, but everyone has said it's so amazing and so good. So I'm hanging in there. I'm like, okay, I know this is a good book. I'm just gonna like give it my best effort and I'm sure it will not disappoint. Like everyone who saw that I was reading it said, oh my gosh, it's so amazing. So I'm excited about this one. It really is written so beautifully. And the chapters are super short too, which makes it a super easy read, at least for me, because I'm one of those people where I cannot stop reading in the middle of a chapter unless it has like a section break, if you know what I mean. Like it does not work for me. My brain's like, I can't compute like stopping in the middle of a chapter somewhere. So I like that I can just flip through a few of these chapters and call it a day. I read this one before bed, which has been really fun. Okay, so the nonfiction that I finished this month is Unseen by Sarah Haggerty. Sorry, it's the gift of being hidden in a world that loves to be noticed. I really liked this book. It is really beautifully written. Sarah Haggerty is an incredible writer. I really like her style of writing. It's very poetic as well. Lots of imagery and symbolism and things like that. So it was harder for me, I guess, to really read and apply it because it was a lot of just reflections and not necessarily like practical, implementable things. Like there is a chapter in here where she goes through like some steps to help you practice being, I guess, present or like to be content in the seasons where you feel more hidden. And that for me was really good. But overall, super, super beautiful, good book that had a ton of takeaways. This is one of those books where I felt like I had to reread a line over and over to let it sink in because it was so good and so deep. That's what I would say. This book is very deep. It's good. It's very deep. Highly recommend if you're someone who likes just reflections, kind of like Present Over Perfect. I read that in January or February this year. Very good. Just a different style of book than something I would normally read for personal development because I'm a very like action steps kind of gal, but still really good. Then, okay, this is the other book I'm reading right now, Vulnerable, Rethinking Human Trafficking by Raleigh Sadler. Oh my gosh, you guys. This book, I feel like I should just do an entire IGTV dedicated to because it is totally changing my life. And I know I've probably said this by now about a couple books that they're just totally life-changing, but it has honestly been life-changing for me. It's just changed my mindset on so many things. Like, I'm really passionate about sex trafficking, but I tend to forget that, or actually what I didn't know is that most human trafficking is labor trafficking, forced labor, sweatshops, those kinds of things. And it talks about that in here. And so it's just really helped expand my perspective and my understanding of human trafficking as a whole, what it looks like, to get a fuller view of what we're actually dealing with when we're talking about fighting human trafficking or playing a role in ending human trafficking. And you guys know that this is something I'm really passionate about, so I'm really excited to be educating myself about this more. And tomorrow I'm actually going to a training that the Net Fort Worth is putting on for human trafficking, or I guess specifically sex trafficking. But I'm just excited to learn more, to educate myself so that I can share with you guys too as I grow my business, because that's always a goal of mine. Like, I would love to always give back to organizations who are doing the work in this field. I feel like it's a good way for me to just like play a small role right now in the season that I'm in as a mom and building a business and things like that. So anyway, this book has been really cool. And if you are interested or passionate or just want to learn more about human trafficking, I cannot recommend this book to you enough. Honestly, like if you just want to learn more about loving people, this is a really good book because the whole premise of it is vulnerability is the main component of human trafficking, really, because human trafficking is the exploitation of someone's vulnerability. And so he talks about how vulnerability is also part of the solution, which I think is just a really beautiful and cool concept because he does talk about it through a gospel lens as well. But man, there's so much in here. I could go on and on about it. If you guys are interested enough, I might just do an entire dedicated IGTV about it because the things I'm learning in this book are like changing the way I think about what I buy, like even my clothes. It talks about how a lot of, you know, labor, forced labor and sweatshops and things like that produce the clothes that we buy and wear in the States a lot, like primarily. And he said something like, how can you assume that the people who made the $5 shirt you got at the store are being paid fairly for their work? Like, if it's that cheap, how can we assume that the people who made it are being paid fairly if they're getting such a small profit? You know what I mean? Anyway, I really could go on and on about it, but I'll leave you with that and just let you know this book is a highly, highly recommended one on my list. I will probably read this once a year for the rest of my life. It's so good. But anyway, that's all for now. I'm finishing up All the Light We Cannot See and Vulnerable this month, and I'm excited to get into some more new books next month. So like I said, if you're interested in any of these, you can check out my Amazon storefront in my bio. And if you want to, you should totally add me on Goodreads so we can see what each other are reading and read together. I think it's just been really fun this year to get back into reading. It's been good. I've mentioned this on the other ones, but just really good for my anxiety, good for my mental health, helping me rest and unwind before bed rather than scrolling. Like, so many benefits to reading besides just like learning new things and expanding my perspective on life and so much. But anyway, I hope that this is encouraging you to read more as well. So you should totally let me know in the comments what you're reading. If you have recommendations for what I should read next, I would love to hear it. I'm always looking for suggestions and ideas for new books that I haven't read before. So let me know and we can read something together. Anyway, I hope that you have a great day and I will talk to you soon.